It is the worst jobless rate in a generation.
U.S. unemployment now running at
10.2%.
Hit hard.
The economy is in trouble. The market again.
We're still seeing the unemployment rate going up
today.
We've taken some extraordinary measures to blunt the hard edges of the worst recession of our lifetime.
The U.S. Labor Department has the full unemployment picture. What is it? 17.5%.
But I'm happy to hear you say you're not going to waste time on a bunch of fishing expeditions and
We don't have time for that.
Because you're right.
We have to get what's going on.
You have to get down and give the folks relief.
Medical costs are also responsible for the jobless numbers because business owners don't want to hire if they absolutely don't need to because health care costs are so expensive.
For many Americans who are counting on President Obama to turn things around.
But as I've said from the moment that I walked into the door of this White House, it took years for us to get into this mess, and it will take us more than a few months to turn it around.
In Silicon Valley, the labor force is more than 800,000 strong. Of those 800,000, the number of unemployed is well over 100,000 and growing rapidly. That's more than 12% unemployed workers just in Silicon Valley. With more than 1 in 10 workers unemployed in the state of California, unemployment has reached the high of 10.5%, the highest jobless rate since June of 1983.
When the recession hit, I said to my students, and you probably were one of them, I said to them, this is just the beginning, because I really believe we're really headed towards a depression. So we need to prepare ourselves. So no, I keep saying to my students, no debt. If you can't afford it, don't buy it. Mm-hmm. Things like that, because we're headed towards that.
I'm here to basically just promote career tech education and to make sure that we build more career tech educational facilities in this state.
We voted him in. He had made all these promises that were never followed through, and look where we are today. In California. Yes, the economy took a dive, and we understand that we can't control that. But yeah, we could have, because we let it get out of control. We did. There was no governing about spending and then once the bubble bursted, it affected everybody, especially education.
Our biggest obstacle is overseas manufacturing for lower production. They still stay here in the States, but for large production, it's all overseas, and that's what's hurting us.
Current recession and unemployment crisis hit us, and it basically hit many of my clients, majority of them. And so it dried up their pockets, so which means there was less income and disposable income for them to get my goods and services. So it has significant impact, and it has been going for a long time.
With our horrendous national deficit, crisis in education, and jobs being outsourced overseas, who will bail us out when the time comes? What legacy are we going to leave for our next generation? Will they be part of the American dream? Or will they entangle themselves in our current American squeeze?
I want to be a doctor. I want to be
like a man. I want to be like my dad when I grow up. Because my dad is a hardworking African American man. And it just makes me proud.